Hey everyone, in 2009 I released a tutorial on the Harry Potter text effect, which was based on the Half-Blood Prince movie poster. With the final movie just around the corner, it's time to update the effect for the Deathly Hallows Part 2. Here's what the final outcome should look like if all goes well. If you want to follow along or download the final PSD, hop over to our Facebook page over at facebook.com/ICEFLOWSTUDIOS and I'll be posting a link along with this video. As for the font, you're free to use any font that you wish, but if you want to use the font that I use in this video, check out dafont.com and search Harry P. Obviously, for copyright reasons, it's not 100% accurate, but it's pretty close. They also have instructions on how to install fonts on your Mac or PC. Like many of my other text effect tutorials, this will be completely composed of layer styles, which means you can easily change the wording later on without messing up the effect too much. As you're following along at home, keep in mind that depending on the size and the font of your text, you will definitely need to adjust some of the settings that I show in this video. Let's begin. Once you have your text typed out, let's start by adding our layer styles. Hop up to the top, go to Layer, Layer Styles, and then we'll start with a gradient overlay. As for the colors, we're going to keep it super simple and use a two-color gradient. The left color is going to be a neutral gray. I'm going to use the value 9E, 9E, 9E. And the right is going to be a lighter gray with a touch of blue. E6, E6, E9. Perfect. And that's all for the gradient. Nice and simple. Next is going to be the bevel and emboss. This will help give our text some shape and texture. We're going to keep the style at inner bevel, but change the technique to chisel hard. Depth is going to be set to 200 and size is 30. Now down into our shading, go ahead and turn off global light and change the angle to 40 and the altitude to 58. For the highlight mode, let's switch it to overlay and set the color to a nice light orange. I'm going to choose E4, D0, C7. This will give a slight tint to our highlights. Opacity can remain at 75%. For the shadow mode, let's use linear burn, and this time we're going to change the color to a darker orange. 5, 2, 2, 2, 1, 3. Opacity for the shadows will be bumped all the way to 100%. Again, a quick reminder, if your text is larger or smaller than mine, you'll probably have to change some of the settings that we just went over. Let's move on and add a contour. When the contour is added, I'm going to simply increase the value to 58%. That's all. Now, the texture is where our text will get the stone feel to it. From the drop-down menu, select the rusted metal texture. It's the red one, right here. Keep the scale at 100%, but change the depth to 30%. Good, it's starting to come along pretty nicely, but we need to add some more color to the side. To do this, let's add an inner shadow. For the blend mode, we're going to choose overlay with pure white for the color. And we're going to crank the opacity all the way to 100%. Now, because our bevel's shadow has a red tint to it, this inner shadow will really help bring some of that color back into focus. And we want the color to be coming directly from the left-hand side. So go ahead and turn off global light and change the angle to 180 degrees. Change the distance to 10 and the size to 15. This will really soften up the color quite a bit. Good, now that we have some red peeking in through the side, we also need to dirty up the text a little bit. Sure, we could do this using grunge brushes, but we want to try and keep the effect 100% editable in the future. Let's try out a satin. Here, let's go ahead and change the blend mode to linear burn, and let's choose a dark grayish blue type color. I'm going to use the value 4C5161. We don't want the dirt to overpower the text, so let's use an opacity of around 45%. At the moment, it's quite sharp, so what we're going to do is change the distance to 100 and the size to 40. Perfect. The last layer style I'm going to add will be an inner glow. This will give a slight glow to some of the dull edges of the text. Change the blend mode to overlay, the opacity to 35%, and choose pure white for the color. Everything else could be left alone. And that's that! Harry Potter text in Photoshop using only layer styles. Again, if you want the final PSD or you want to show off your result from this tutorial, head over to our Facebook page or at facebook.com/ICEFLOWSTUDIOS. Take care!